Hello, I am Sharon Beekman, Chair of the EPC Women's Resource Council. The Council administers the EPC Women's Ministry, called the WELL, Women's Resources. We exist to serve you, women in EPC churches, and we want to help you connect with the EPC women across our denomination and to provide resources for ministry in the local church. Please visit our website, blog, and Facebook group. The link to the blog and Facebook can be found on the EPC website. On the website, you'll also find vetted resources on discipleship, evangelism, healing, prayer, and leadership. We selected ones to help you grow in your love for Christ, to be bold in your faith, and to be equipped to serve Him. The resources are biblically based and theologically sound. In our video series, council members want to bless you as they share personal experiences and insights in their journey with Christ. Please take a few minutes to hear Kim Sinclair, a member of Grace Chapel in Farmington Hills, Michigan. She will discuss her and her husband's experience with infertility. She is interviewed by Lynn Burge, a ruling elder for Faith Presbyterian Church in Germantown, Tennessee.
Kim, when you and your husband got married, was it your plan to have children one day?
Absolutely. I was in my early 30s when we got married, and we were very, very anxious to start a family as soon as we could.
How did you learn that you would never be able to have children of your own?
I had had serious health issues from the time I was 20, and by the time I was 30, I was diagnosed with endometriosis, which is a very devastating diagnosis for women. It was difficult. We found out 2 weeks before our wedding that I could never bear children, and I was quite frustrated and upset at the time.
Did you and your husband ever consider adoption?
We talked about it. My biological clock was ticking a little faster than his, as I'm a few years older than he is. But unfortunately, by the time we decided that that was a possibility for us, I was already too old to consider adoption. And an overseas adoption was just out of the question for us at the time.
How did you deal with that realization that you would never be a mother?
I think over time, God healed my heart. Because I prayed for that. It was also interesting to have others love on me in such a way that it really showed His love. For instance, one of my very closest friends, when her daughter was getting married, invited me to come to the bridal salon to share in that experience because she knew I would never have the opportunity to do that with my own daughter.
Tell me, what is it like to meet with other women who are mothers?
It was very difficult much of the time, because if you've ever noticed in conversations with your friends, much of the discussion surrounds having children and what they're experiencing. And although that's a wonderful thing and you can certainly empathize with their situation, it can feel very isolating and difficult. I think it's important that we remember that we are first daughters of the King and then we are mothers. It's important also that we remember to be inclusive in our conversations so that other women don't feel excluded or devalued in any way.
What counsel can you give to other women who are in a situation like yours where they were never going to be able to have that experience?
First and foremost, keep your eyes on God, because He is the lover of our souls and He will heal your heart. And then I would say surround yourself with children of other families, whether they're family members or friends, and become a role model to those children and just love them completely.
I hope this discussion has been a blessing to you. For more information on the WELL, please see our website and blog and connect with us on social media. Thank you for watching, and may God richly bless you today.